you ever felt overwhelmed with your inbox? I used to struggle with it so much, and in this video today, I want to provide you with the tools to make sure that you are not spending too much time in your emails and you're doing it productively so you can spend more time doing things that you actually enjoy. I don't think anyone in the world enjoys sorting emails. Today I will be introducing a zero inbox approach. You might have heard about it before, and I've been trying it for a couple of months now, so I think I grasp the idea of it, and I will share the information that will help you to get to proper zero inbox in small steps. So what is zero inbox? The idea is, as it sounds, it's having zero emails in your inbox. So how do you achieve it? The first step is going to be archiving all your emails. I get into that in a second. And then you are unsubscribing from all the junk mail or all the newsletters that you don't need. And after that, you are taking care of emails as they come. And that is a very important thing to do if you want to implement it properly. And also, you create filters to help you automatically sort some emails that you don't really have to sort manually. So we will start from the basics and archiving. I'm using Gmail for this video because that is something that I'm familiar with the most, but most of these steps you can recreate in Outlook and in other services that you might be using. The first and the most important step toward zero inbox is archiving. And what archiving does, it hides all your emails from the inbox, it doesn't show them there, but it also stores them. So when you are archiving your emails, they're not getting deleted, they're still accessible in your mail account. In case with Gmail, if you want to archive an email, you can just tick the box here and you just press archive, and that's it. Where did it go? Now it's in all mail tab, where you can access everything that you archived previously. As you can see, many of these emails have labels. We will get to the labels a bit later. Technically, that's zero inbox, archiving everything. And after you press this button, after you select everything and you archive it, that's it. It's out of your inbox. Your inbox is empty. Congratulations, you've achieved zero inbox. But you don't expect it to be that easy, do you? So the hardest thing about zero inbox is actually maintaining it. So if you feel like you don't want to do anything more than that, I would recommend you to go through your inbox, see what's important, reply to those emails, archive everything else, and then let emails accumulate and repeat this step, say once in 2 weeks. That's how I've been doing it for the first couple of months while getting used to the concept of zero inbox. The best thing that happens after you do that, you are able to see who actually messages you the most, whether there are some repetitive promotions, and having zero inbox allows you to have a fresh look on what is actually going on with your inbox, who is spamming you. So if you're looking for an easy way to get into the habit, I highly recommend archiving everything. And then as soon as you're being hit with a newsletter that you don't want to read, you just unsubscribe from it right there and then. And I promise it's going to make a big difference. You don't exactly have to sort your emails to start doing that, but to those of you who woke up and chose violence, I'll show you an efficient way to declutter your inbox or your all mail. Let's go to the archive. In my case, that is all mail tab, and in Gmail, that is where your archive is going to be. And what you want to do is you want to skim through your emails, maybe 5 pages deep, and see who are the most frequent messengers are. So if I go to the first page, I have this awful email that keeps messaging me all the time, despite me desperately trying to unsubscribe. But what you usually want to do to get rid of those emails, obviously you can hit unsubscribe. In this case, it's not going to do absolutely anything because there is some filthy marketing going on. But what you want to do to get rid of all the previous emails from the sender is just copy the email address that the mail was sent from, and then you paste it to the search tab and press enter. And that's gonna show all the messages from the sender, as you can see, in just a couple of days. In a span of 2 days, I received 4 emails, which is way too much for any sender. All right, and so what I'm gonna do next is I will just select them and delete them. I recommend doing this step first and then get into filters. We'll get to them a bit later in the video. Because of the GDPR, many email senders that used to spam you in the past will not be sending emails now. So what we want to achieve is to get rid of frequent senders that are spamming you currently. I have received quite a few messages from UPS in the past, so one more way that you can clean your inbox, because companies often use different names in their emails. If you want to make sure that you are hitting all the emails from this domain, you are just copying everything that comes after at. You are copying it, pasting it, you select it, pick what you need, and then you just delete it, because I don't need that information anymore. I'm not too worried about it. And if I haven't looked for it over the past year, chances are I'm not gonna need it in the future. If you have several thousand emails in your inbox, this step can easily take hours. Repeat the search bar trick until you're so tired you cannot get off your chair. After you've done this cleanup, I recommend you using generic search terms that will help you to clean your inbox even further. So we are gonna be looking for phrases like temporary password verification code, it's now on sale, you have a new message, reply to your message, survey, provide your feedback, how did we do, and all of that. I will copy the phrases that I found the most common in my inbox. They're gonna be in the description, so you can just copy them and paste them straight into your email search box, and we're gonna do the same. So for example, if I will put verification code in search, a couple of things will come up, and I will make sure that I'm deleting everything. Skim through the emails, don't delete them blindly if you know that some of the senders might be sending you sensitive information. For the love of God, do not use Maelstrom. They're gonna spam you and you won't be even able to delete your account. So I've heard this tool being mentioned before. Steer away from it because it brings more trouble than help. If you are in a mood to share your personal data, you can try CleanFox. CleanFox works like Tinder for your subscription, so you're just swiping on things that you want to keep and you don't want to keep. I personally found it a bit useless because there is very little flexibility to this application. But if you are feeling extremely lazy, you don't want to get into filters and labels and all of that, you may give it a try. I think the developers of this app are working in the right direction, but I feel like this application could use a few improvements, and it's available on iOS and Android in case you want to give it a go. But remember, it collects your data. It doesn't share it with third parties, but they keep and analyze your data. If you're going for a deep clean, this application is not gonna help you. I think doing it manually at first is the best way to go. And then through the automations, through the shortcuts, we can make sure that we maintain zero inbox. To further refine your email letters and make sorting even easier, I'm gonna show you keyboard shortcuts that are gonna make your life much easier. So in order to turn on keyboard shortcuts, let's go to settings, see all settings, and then advanced. And we need to make sure that custom keyboard shortcuts are enabled. After that, if you would like to see all the shortcuts, you can open the keyboard shortcuts tab, and there's going to be a list where you are also able to adjust them, to customize them. If some of the features are not working for you, make sure that you have smart features and personalization turned on. And after that, in our still general settings menu, we are looking for auto advance. This is my favorite thing about Gmail. And over here, I would suggest to turn on go to the previous or older conversation. What it does is when you open an email and you deal with it, for example, from all mail, or you have a couple of emails in your inbox, after you archive it or after you delete it, it takes you to another message in your inbox, so you don't have to click around. You can pick go to next newer conversation. Some people prefer that. I personally prefer go to previous older conversation because I'm going from the newest to the oldest emails. In the same menu, make sure that your keyboard shortcuts are on, that you can use them when you are in your inbox or in your archive. After you make any changes in settings, do not forget to save it. That's very important. Now let's go to our archive and see how we can use everything that we just turned on. So after you've opened an email in your archive and say you don't need it, you delete it, what Gmail does now, it jumps to the next oldest email, and it's brilliant. It makes it so much easier. You don't have to jump around too much. And now using your keys J and K, you can jump in between emails real fast and you don't have to go back to the archive. So you can delete them as well. And it's really great. It helps you to even further refine your inbox, and it's super helpful. And I highly recommend using these two shortcuts. If you manage to make the delete shortcut work, it's brilliant. But keep in your head that these shortcuts work properly only with English letters, and they get very finicky in other languages. Now let's get into labels. Labels is the tool that allows you to sort emails that go into your inbox. You can combine them with archiving, and then you can just jump into label folders so you can open the emails that you need. So how do you apply labels? So you go to your inbox, you pick a letter, you can apply label straight from this menu, and you can do the same when you have this email opened. So you are going to labels tab, and you pick a label that you want to apply. In my case, it's going to be streaming. I click apply, and if I still need this email in the future, I simply archive it, and later in my labels tab I will be able to access it. So currently I'm using four labels to sort the emails, and I use a couple more for the automations or for something that I might need to refer to in the future. Most of the time I use four labels that help me to sort most of the email letters that hit my inbox. I'm using a waiting for label, I'm using reply label, I also use newsletters and shopping. If I have an email and I don't have time to reply to it, I mark it with a reply label and I archive it. You can also mark a message as unread, or you can create a filter that everything that drops into any of these folders is gonna stay unread, and that way you can keep up with everything that is going to your inbox. It's very easy and intuitive. Newsletters are for newsletters and any interesting information that I might want to refer to later. Reply is for everything that I need to take care of, everything that I'm responsible for. And then shopping for everything orders related, receipts, and waiting for folder is for something that is in progress, but something that I'm not responsible for, but I'm still involved in it. And these four folders cover most of the emails that go to my inbox. Now let's say you want to create a filter. You want to automate your inbox and help Gmail sort emails on your behalf. For each case, you can create a separate filter. For example, I sometimes receive email letters from Twitch after my stream is ready. And what you can do, you can select this email and then click three buttons here. You can do it from the email menu as well. And you select filter messages like these. And now you can write the conditions for your automations for what Gmail is going to do with messages just like this one. So in my case, it hooks up no reply at Twitch TV. Most of these emails, as you can see, are not something that I immediately need, so I want to archive them. So what I do, I make sure that all the conditions are right. In my case, this information is enough. I click create filter, and now I get to choose what Gmail does with this letter when in the future it hits my inbox. So in this case, I want to make sure that it skips the inbox, that I mark it as read, because I definitely will not need it immediately. It's not news for me. And then I apply the label streaming, where I sort everything stream related. And then I click also apply filter to all matching conversation. What it's gonna do, it's gonna collect all the emails that match this criteria that you received in the past, and it's gonna apply this rule to all of them. So then you click create filter, and boom, everything is now archived, including the email that you selected, including everything that's going to hit your inbox in the future. And you repeat this rule for every email that you know is going to be repetitive, for email address that sends you repetitive content that you don't immediately need. You can apply these filters for anything you want. If you want, say, to sort your emails, you can apply it. If you want to have labels and sort emails by the client, that is also possible. You can use the search terms, the email size, and filters are a great help into cementing zero inbox. They are your biggest and greatest tool to achieve zero inbox. One more thing that can be very helpful when you're looking for something, and especially if you're tight on your space, you can search for emails more than, say, 5 megabytes. You click it and you see that this email has an attachment that is more than 5 megabytes. So if you're struggling with freeing up space, this is something that you can use. You can also use other commands in the search bar. I will link the list of all the Gmail commands in the description. You can search emails by date. You can search for emails no older than 3 days. It's a very helpful tool, and I hope you find it useful. Zero inbox requires some maintenance, and don't feel down if in 2 months after implementing the system, you still have junk mail. Take your time, filter everything, unsubscribe from everything, and enjoy your zero inbox. I'm yet to achieve a perfect zero inbox, but I've made great progress over these couple of months, and it helped me greatly to battle unwanted emails and pre-sort everything. And one day I realized that my email inbox is just dry, and I never realized that emails are a part of a dopamine routine, same as social media. And implementing the system brought some discomfort to my life, because I was so used to a constant flow of information through my email inbox. Roughly after 2 weeks of properly implementing the system, I realized that my inbox is completely dry because I got rid of all the unwanted newsletters, which apparently were the majority of the letters I received. Don't get discouraged if you can't implement this right away. It took me a couple of months to start using this, and I still have some labels to take care of and emails in archives to clean. That is part of it. But the main thing about zero inbox is how you take care of your emails in the future. So don't beat yourself for not taking care of them in the past. All that matters is that now you know exactly how to achieve the inbox freedom. I hope you found this video useful. If I missed something, please do let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for sticking around, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye now.